What's going on, guys, and welcome to another indie horror Let's Play playthrough, my friends. This is called Madhouse. This is actually a project by some students at UCF, I believe. It's supposed to be pretty good. It's supposed to be pretty eerie. It's based off a insane asylum, so if you couldn't guess by the name Madhouse, looks pretty good. From my experience, if you're working on a project in college, usually you put some time and effort into it, so I really look forward to diving into this, and I appreciate you guys for putting all this hard work into it. Of course, if you guys want to know more about the game, it's in the description below, along with the sub link if you guys want to sub to the channel if you like what we're doing here. Also, my Twitter is there, so you know when I go live next, and I'll do these live most times, so you guys can join me. Also, we have a Patreon if you guys want to become a VIP member of Team Pennywise and show some love. It's never expected, but always appreciated. I appreciate you guys so much. And by the way, to show you guys I appreciate you guys, remember the last video that is from Five Nights at Freddy's is a free copy of Five Nights at Freddy's sister location. If you guys follow the instructions in there, you'll have a chance to get me in a little while. So keep that in mind. Can't wait to see
this
what
is it.
All about.
Lockwood Manor Mental Facility. No one's been here in years.
Okay.
I can't see a thing.
There is a lot. Is that spirit orbs? I'm big on the paranormal, and those look like spirit orbs in here. And it looks like there's golden spirit orbs above. Above a phone? Oh, flashlight.
What did that letter say again?
There we go. 1941 registered nurse Rebecca Flynn. Oh! So it's going to be a jump back and forth to her story, I guess?
Hello?
And the private investigator trying to figure out what happened?
Hey, darling, do me a favor and take this radio.
Really cool idea. Oh, take the radio. There we go. There's a lot of spirit orbs around the phone. Now there's nothing.
Look, it's procedure that I lock down the mess hall and stay here with the patients. Could you go get the keys to the maintenance closet? They should be in the warden's office.
She's so polite, isn't she?
Sure, I'm on it.
They're both kind of nice to each other. I like that. Sure. No kidding. We're in a mental hospital. We might get killed at any moment, but sure, I got you. I got you. It's no big deal. Oh, that kind of just opened, didn't it? 1951 private investigator Darren Hall. We're back to Darren Hall. That's cool. Just painting the story.
There's something weird about this place.
It sure as hell seems that way, my friend. Alright, we're back here at the desk. So, that door is already open. Which is very strange, because I opened that with the other person. Oh. Now there's spirit orbs. Oh, what is that? Somebody didn't turn the tub off. Really digging the environment so far, my little input on it. I like the use of kind of spirit orby material to indicate something that, you know, is of interest.
I'll take a closer look at this later.
Lockwood Manor, mental facility, applicants, personal records, notes. Job applied, nursing aide for Rebecca Flynn. Okay, so this is her application for a job. Found nurse wanted ad in the newspaper, says she is seeking employment near Westville. Passionate about taking care of others, assisting those in need. She left previous occupants surgical assistant because of undisclosed reasons. She's hopeful that she can make a difference here and improve lives. Reason for hire, has experience taking care of patients and unruly children. Schedule works well. Enthusiastic about creating new lives for patients. Could use a more cheerful persona. More chill for your end. Oh my god. Yes, very, very much more cheerful. I don't know what school you worked at, but if this is more cheerful, I don't want to be at that school ever. Ever. That's insane. Okay. We got that. So let's go through this door that we stopped going through before. Ooh. my god, what is that? What is that? Is it only there? Oh, what is that? What is that sound? Oh no, it's over here too.
What is this?
I have no idea what it is, man. You tell me. Oh, looks like those little things are gonna reach out and tickle me. Okay. I'm just going for it. Why not, right? If I get scared, I mean, you know. It's all good. I got this. Bunch of spirit orbs everywhere. Why'd that just happen? Strange heart pump. Okay, can't get in there, so it has to be this way. Okay. Okay. Oh god, Jesus! Dude, really? Okay. Alright. You got me. You got me. Alright. Cool. Alright. Alright. What in the hell was that? It's like some psychopath. Oh, I don't want to go down there, dude. Oh my god. Please don't kill me. Okay, alright. I think that was it. Is that it? Okay. Oh! Hey!
This could make good evidence.
Lockwood Manor Mental Facility Psychologist Report. Name. What are these voices? Holy crap. Hi, James. Admitted to hospital 12/21/1940. Dr. Frank Norris. Reason for session after a week of silence in our meetings. Hyde explained. That's pretty awesome. Hyde explained. He hospitalized himself, but fails to recall the incident. Wait, the inciting incident, which means he failed to even, like, he doesn't know why he's there. He didn't even know he admitted himself. My lord. Patient may be suffering from mild amnesia. Makes sense. He has been able to eat and missed work for a week, but admitted himself due to an anonymous letter of recommendation. He's noticed he has gotten progressively worse since being here. Causing fights with other patients, attempting to hear himself, and trying to hear unknown voices, like what I'm hearing right now. It's freaking crazy. He even describes things that do not seem real. I suggest some time in solitary. He refused. My professional opinion is that Mr. Hyde should remain in solitary until the voices he claims to hear cease. Patient needs time alone to improve. Admitted to high security ward, claiming room. So why would you put someone there by himself that's shouldn't you like just try to help him, not just throw him in a room somewhere and tell him to get over it? Oh my lord. Okay, more stringy things. Please don't jump out. Please don't jump out. Okay. Is that open? Oh god, please no. Okay. Hello? What is going on here? Okay. What are these things? Investigate. What the hell? 1941 patient 14 James Hyde. Ooh, I get to be James Hyde. That's neat. I like how they're doing the story so far. Good job, guys. Oh, what in the Fruit Loops is this?
Solitary confinement.
Okay.
How did I get here?
Very colorful. Way to use your imagination, Mr. Hyde.
Oh no. I have to get out of here.
Yeah, see, he doesn't know anything. Look at the blood and the things. Okay. There's some that are swaying a little bit more than others. Okay. All right. What is this? Oh, what the hell? Oh, look! It's like a key map. Red R, like a R, shit. Purple circle, and then green. Huh. What the hell is this? Oh! Oh, wait, okay. So what order does that go in then? Purple, red, or red, purple, green, purple? Okay, so there should be two purples. Red, purple, purple, green. But, okay, so red, purple, green, purple. Let's try that. Red, purple, green, and purple. Oh, look at us, man. Wow, that was pretty cool. Okay, now we're back. 1951 Private Investigator Darren Hall. We're back to Mr. Darren Hall. Let's investigate.
What was that noise? It sounded like it came from the stairwell.
Oh, God. New journal entry. What do we got? Okay, 3. Memory log number 2. Power is on. Patient Hyde acts peculiar and sees unrealistic things. Voices whisper to him. Patient escapes solitary confinement. Patient seems very troubled. He saw things I have never heard of before. I wonder how he was able to escape his room performing such a strange task. I wonder where he is headed. Did I read this one too? No, I didn't. Memory log number 1, year 1941. Power went out. Head nurse Barbara Moore introduced herself to new staff member. Nurse name is Rebecca Flynn. Nurse Flynn was told to get a key from the warden's office. Okay. She was also told to check on patient James Hyde in the infirmary. I bet this was Nurse Flynn's folder. It looked like she was a newly hired nurse here at Lockwood Manor. She was asked to head to the warden's office by head nurse Barbara to retrieve the maintenance keys to restore power. I found some strange black mass in the lobby, maybe a mold of some kind. What kind of mold is that? I should be careful not to breathe. Yes, you should be careful not to breathe. Okay. Continuing on, hopefully not getting the crap scared out of us. Or maybe hopefully. You never know. Okay. What do we got? Didn't it? Okay. Wasn't that not in the way before?
What the hell? This was blocked before.
Don't turn off the light! Oh, 1941 registered nurse Rebecca Flynn. Back to Miss Rebecca. Okay. What are we doing?
I need to find the keys.
You need to find the keys.
Not over here.
Okay. Oh, okay, I like this. She's telling me where to go. I like this. Somehow I feel like it might be that door. What is this? Missing child, suspicious government activity in Hawkins, Indiana. Things are getting stranger. It says Dungeons and Dragons on it. Look at that. Did you see that? Dungeons and Dragons in the left corner. Wow, that's cool. I like that. This is quite strange. Okay.
Where are they?
Oh, I don't want to be in here. Oh, there's little sparkly things. Okay. Oh, there's
the keys. I found the keys.
Great. Maintenance is just through medical.
Goliath Game Studios, Fog 17. GG, Goliath Game Studios. Good job, buds. Enjoying it so far. It's got a good story. I like how you go back and forth, kind of like in time or something like that. To figure out the story. Pretty cool so far. Sorry, I was paying attention. Oh my goodness, trying to at least. Okay. Go here.
What's going on here?
I don't know. You tell me. Okay, yes, we go here. Oh, here we go. 1951 private investigator Darren Hall again. Okay, let's do this big dog Darren Hall.
She went to medical. I should head that way.
Oh, cool. We go up the stairs now. Hey. Okay, so we can follow where we went before with her. Make sure we look for any. What the hell was that? Blood on the floor. Am I dying or something? I ingest something. Oh, what the fuck is that? Okay. Alright. Okay. Calm down. Oh my god. There's more goopy goop. More goopy goops in the corner. Oh! Okay, there's more shiny things. Oh! What is this?
I'll take a closer look at this.
Dear
later.
Mary, it's been forever and a day since I've seen you. You haunt my thoughts. I know you saw my work, my masterpiece. You may not approve. Return home and we'll see the beauty. What? Did he, like, murder his family or something? I promise these things you saw were not human anymore, and were never functional members of society like we are. They were a burden, parasites. I hope you can come to realize I was helping them, and I can help you. I have big plans for big plans that turns this manor into a hospital for all the hopeless folk out there. Ooh. So this used to be a home turned into a manor hospital. Very peculiar. It'll be my magnum opus. Return me so we may continue where we left off. So we may make a difference in this world of heathens. Yours forever, Charles Lockwood. Okay, so Lockwood Manor, blah, blah, blah. Oh my, stop whispering in my ear. That is so creepy. Okay, still a bunch of spirit orbs everywhere. That is really crazy. Okay, what does this say? Person in an asylum reads newspaper while creature appears behind them. That's not funny. Okay. Woo. Very clever. Very clever. Very clever. I'll give you that. That was good. I've never seen that in a game before. Very unique. There we go. Here's where she was, right? Okay, what on earth is that? Okay, bloodstained. Oh, back to patient James Hyde. Patient 14.
Okay. Oh. Oh no.
Mr. James Hyde. What is? I'm feeling kind of frantic here. I'm retracing these. Oh, what is this? Oh my god. Oh, I see. It's some kind of like. Okay. Some kind of like. Oh, go! Oh, yeah, we got it. We got a first time. That was like some kind of maze or something. So, okay, where do we go now? Okay, here we go. Yeah! That went too bad. Okay, now we're on the other side. We're doing it! Nothing shiny, right? Ooh, we can go in there. What on earth is this? There's nothing shiny in here, is there? Oh, wait. Chainsaw death toll continues to rise. Chainsaw blade rentals. Runner sets new record. Okay. I like to look at little Easter eggs like that in games. Might hide something cool like we just found. Oh! Here we go, there's the power. Oh, it fell off! Did you see it? 1951. Private Investigator Darrow Hall. Let's go, Mr. Darrow Hall.
What the hell? This was blocked before.
I'm changing the present by going in the past and doing different things. That's a unique concept. I have to give it to you guys. Okay. Shiny thing over here.
This could make good evidence.
Longwood Manor mental facility operator report patient named Hyde James, date of birth 1906, date of operation 2/12/1941. Operation Electroconvulsive Therapy, Dr. William Harris, assistant to Barbara Moore. Indication for procedure. Patient Hyde is found speaking to himself again and believing he is seeing things that are not there. Patient talks about a man that has been conversing with him in his ward. When asked what this man looks like, patient gives no real description of human features. This is the third treatment. No signs of improvement. Increased voltage to 200. Yikes. Procedure in detail. Patient Hyde was brought to the medical ward, strapped to a carrier. Patient screamed and tried to strike assistant Moore while being moved to operation table. Yeah, you guys are about to volt him up. I'd be screaming like a little crazy dude, too. Once patient was securely strapped down, procedure began. Patient's temples were prepared and ECT machine was fastened on. Assistant Moore placed her hand at the patient's chin. Voltage adjusted from 150 to 200. Voltage was administered. Patient let out a blood-curdling scream. And rubber block was placed in her mouth. Patient's body began to violently contract while ECT machine was removed. Patient's body was still. Hyde was transferred to carrier and returned to his cell. Okay, so you throw the guy in his cell. You take him out. And you zap the crap out of him. And you throw him back in the cell. Man, that is insane. That is so bad. Okay. Yeah, this way. Yeah. Okay. And then this door opened. Oh, there. Oh, here we go. Pick that up. Back to Rebecca. Okay. Man, this is like morphing time and going back and forth to do different things as different people at different times. And yeah.
Okay, where's the power switch?
It's right there. Got this.
Rebecca, didn't you turn the power back on?
Yes?
I did. It must have. It's working.
Well, crap. Let's go. Guess we gotta go around the corner here now. I did not want to do that. Ooh, what is this stuff? Oh. Okay, back ahead of time to 51 with Mr. Darren.
Christ, what was that?
Yeah, I don't know. You got me. Can I put the handle back on this sucker? Okay. Alright. Let's go back. Let's follow the footsteps of everyone. Ooh. No, you don't.
Okay. There's something weird about this place.
Did you just... this guy is a great investigator. Did he just put that together? There's weird things that are tickling me coming out of this sludge substance, but... I am just now realizing that there is something weird about this place. Man. I enjoy the game so far, though. It's a great game. Good stuff. Okay. Finish line? James Hyde, back to 41. Why is this music playing? Why am I running? What do we do? God, what's happening?
No.
Oh, I'm just running. I'm just running.
Get away.
I'm just running, dude. Oh, God. Oh, yeah. Go. Oh, God. Oh god. Oh god, just run. Where do I go? Oh, where do I go? Oh!
Not again.
Oh my god, I just came back to the where I was. Okay. Okay, that's the wrong way, apparently.
Not again.
Okay. Right. Okay. Then we take a left. Yes, okay. Oh, Jesus! Oh my god. Why? Why do that to me? Take another right? Oh, you son of a gun.
Not again.
Oh god, where do we go from here? Okay. So we took a right. Okay. And we took a left. Right, right. We took a left. Now we're gonna take a left instead of a right. Oh god, that's scary. Oh, where do we go? Where do we go? Right? Oh god, so what? Oh. Okay. That was really strange. I guess we go for it. I'm just gonna go where it's got me facing. There we go.
The voices. Ooh. Please, no!
Oh god! He got pulled in. 51 Darren Hall, oh my god.
Whoa, Christ, dude. What was that?
Yeah, seriously. Okay, new journal entry. Let's check it out. What we got? Chapter 6. Oh, we're on 7. Okay, let's go 6 real fast. Power. Okay, we need to go to 5. Sorry. Let me see if 4 is good still. Good, okay, 5. Power's on. Here's mocking voices. Patient Hyde found his way to maintenance. Patient destroyed power breaker. Ooh, the patient destroyed the power breaker. Runs downstairs. So he didn't know he did it, but he actually destroyed the power breaker. Christ, he seems to be suffering from a serious case of schizophrenia. That explains the weird voices and peculiar things he thinks is happening. He destroyed the power breakers. Is that the same outage Rebecca experienced? Huh. Memory number 5. Power is off and turned back on, and another voice is speaking to her. Nurse Flynn repaired power breaker. Nurse Moore orders to go to lobby. Am I like voices and weird things talking to people throughout time? This is really strange and a really cool concept. Nurse Moore orders to get her to go to the lobby. The same voice that spoke to patient Hyde is now speaking to Rebecca. Maybe he isn't as schizophrenic as I was made to believe. She restored the power, at least tried to. She headed back to the lobby, made find James. I'm beginning to think this isn't mold, it's getting worse. Memory log number 6. Power is off, patient Hyde runs, smoke fills the halls, in obscured lobby, enters bright room, disappearance. What is happening? I hear the same voices as patient Hyde did. He ran down what seemed like a never-ending hallway and made it to the lobby. That did happen. What is drawing him to the vile room? I must find out what happened here. Okay.
Darren, is that you? What's going on here?
Seriously? Are you talking to me? Oh my god, this is weird, man. Cool, though. 1941 registered nurse Rebecca Flynn. Once again, Miss Flynn. Let's keep investigating. Oh. Okay. Excuse me. So there's lights. Okay, there's lights. Whoa. There's more lights. I'm assuming I run to the lights. Oh, God. Okay. Oh, I wasn't fast enough. Right, let's go. It's always the furthest one, right?
Ow.
I'm going. Run to the lights. It's cool. Alright, I got you. We got this. Nope, it's not that one. She's like, ah! Oh, where's it at? Oh! Go. Don't die on me. Oh! Oh, I did it. Oh my god.
Hello? Who's down there?
Don't do that. No. Don't you go into that room. back to Darren. Oh my god, this game's creepy, man.
What is going on?
I'd like to know myself. I'm sure this is chapter 8, right? Yep. Okay. Power's flickering. Nurse Flynn is Flynn in lobby. Nurse more frustrated. Seeing strange things. Disappearance. Oh god, I'm seeing the same thing as patient Hyde. Nurse Flynn is as well. The mold has been blocked in. What is the smoke? What's down those stairs? I'm going. Let's do it. Then. She's all gung-ho. Let's do this then. Look out for some shiny things, that's for sure. Alright, we're good. Oh. Okay. This is the door. Oh, okay. Please don't pull me into some creepy.
Ah!
Oh!
In tonight's news, local private investigator Darren Hall was reported missing. He was last seen entering North Lockwood. If you have any information on Mr. Hall's whereabouts, please contact your local authorities.
Now he's missing too. Oh my god. Holy hell. Can I get out of here?
A Westfield woman was reported missing today. The woman was last seen walking her dog in North Lockwood. Her husband called in the disappearance when the dog returned home alone. If you have any information, please call the local authorities.
It's not letting me go. Well, shoot, man. Good job, guys. Man, that was Madhouse, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed. Show some love to the creators if you guys want. Again, in the video description will be all the information on what the game's about. Subscribe if you guys like what we're doing here. If you want to be a VIP member, of course, please hit up the Patreon. Like I said before, it's always appreciated and never expected. But mad love to you all. I appreciate you guys so much. Don't forget to get your free copy of Sister Location if you do win the giveaway on the Five Nights at Freddy's video. So, until next time, guys, it's been a pleasure. Peace!